Yeah, there's a lot of quality of life things I have to check out too. I've seen it all. I've seen it all, Heb. I saw the dev stream, so let's find out what happened. Might be a bit too loud. We'll see.
What happened to this place?
It was Sephiroth.
He wants to finish what he started and rule over the planet.
We have to help them.
You coming?
Woo! There's Yuffie.
I will reclaim our world.
Okay, that was the trailer that dropped a couple weeks ago.
Square Enix の北瀬義則です。私がシリーズプロデューサーを務めるファイナルファンタジー7の最新作ファイナルファンタジー7リバースが
February 29th, last day of February.
本作のストーリーは主人公クラウドとその仲間たちが宿敵であるセフィオスを追いかけ魔法都市ミッドガルの外にある広大な世界へと足を踏み出すところから物語が始まります。
Okay.
今回のステートプレイではこのゲームの魅力を凝縮した。
Okay, so from what we've learned, we already know we're gonna go outside and explore the world. The game is gonna end on the like the game is gonna end in the ancient ruins where the OG Final Fantasy VII Disc 2 ended, and also it's gonna be two discs. We're gonna get the tiny Bronco. We're gonna get, I believe we might get Highwind. I'm not too positively sure. But everything is gonna be out. Open world, everything. So I'm expecting weapons. I wanna see weapons in this trailer. The new trailer is gonna come out. I wanna say weapons. I wanna say demo. And I wanna say Sephiroth playability. I want them to showcase all of that. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm gonna constantly pause here.
Cloud, bring me the black materia.
Okay, so the black materia, this is actually loud for me, my own standards. The black materia, I believe, is the one that you find in the, what do you call that? The pyramid structure or whatever, where you have to bring Aerith to. And, yeah, where you take Caith Sith and then the whole thing explodes and then Caith Sith passes. There it is. Yep. The ancient ruins where you find the red dragon. I remember this.
The beginning of the end.
Oh! Wait, that looks so cool. Is it the ancient ruins?
The beginning.
Oh, look at that. Wait, yeah, this is the ancient ruins. Wait, hold on. I'm sorry for pausing, but like, yeah, this is the jungle, and then this is the bridge you go into, and that this is the whole pyramid that like disappears when you put the when you take away the black materia.
Beginning of the end.
Oh, that's insane. It's so big. That is beautiful. Oh my lord. That is so big. And imagine we're gonna explore all of this plus the rest of the world to the extent of my 1:1 ratio. I think it's 1:1. I don't exactly know. But like I think it's like if it's real life. Look how good and detailed that looks. Oh, that's amazing. I cannot wait to play this game. Jesus Lord.
For all mankind. Hey kids, sorry we were late.
Sick fight. Woo! Oh, who's that? Wait. I wanna see who that is. I don't recall that monster. I'm trying to remember. I don't know the bestiary of all of Final Fantasy VII. I only know some of them because I farmed the heck out of them for weapon drop. I don't remember this monster. Ooh. Oh, she. Oh, Aerith, one of the shades. That's amazing. Wait, is this, who is this guy? This is Cid. Freak. What's his face? I forgot his face. I need to do a quick YouTube search. Wait, I gotta do a quick YouTube search. I forgot this guy's name. I remember this guy was in the Sid match where you recruit Sid. FF7 boss fights. That's remake. Nah, I'm talking about OG. There you go. I'm talking about OG. Who is this guy's name again? Palmer, there you go, from Rocket Town. Oh, he looks cool. I like him.
Hey! Now, who wants to be the first
Don Cornelio?
Lady? Hey, boss, your guests are here.
Who's this guy? Oh, wait, is that the guy from Gold Saucer? Is that the Gold Saucer guy?
At long last, the knave returns.
Gilgamesh?
I refuse to be upstaged a second time, my friend!
My friendo.
Good, Cloud. Very good. Fill your hollow heart with rage.
The world will be saved, but will you? What?
I'm back now, Aerith. I'm back.
Oh, that detail.
Ask that you retrieve it. The black materia. Key to our oblivion. Please.
Wait, so they're adding storyline content to the black materia? Because I always wondered what the heck was the reason for that black materia, but they never supported the storyline or a context behind that game or behind that reasoning. Sephiroth really just said he just wants the black materia because it'll just like overpower him and make the comet like appear or something like that. But in the end, we literally lost translation and we just went after the Holy Land. And like he decided to summon the comet after, like, spoilers, Aerith dies. He decided to summon the comet. And that was the whole key context because of that black materia. But we never got to truly find out why he, like, what was the purpose of that.
Alone can liberate us from this endless dream.
Passing through?
Wait, who's this?
You.
Tifa!
Oh, it's Casa de Sol!
Hey, guys!
They're getting some sun too, huh?
Look at all these nice costumes! They actually equipped them with, like, the actual costumes from the, Junon Harbor.
Well, Red, how do we look?
How do you guys think they look? I think they look phenomenal.
Huh?
You should get yourself a ring!
There's the... Oh!
It's gotta be hiding some ginormous materia!
God, I love the song. Cosmo Canyon. Nibelheim. Wait, can I go back? I want to see all the places they went to. So I think this is the forest area. This is where you just get out of, like, straight out of Midgar, towards June, after Mithril Caverns, towards Junon Harbor. Reactor core. Huh? Where is this? I wonder where this is. This looks like... I want to say this is Nibelheim in the reactor section, but I don't think it is. Because it wasn't this green and grassy and stuff. I want to say this is possibly a new area we haven't explored before. Perchance maybe Midgar after everything happened? There's Cosmo Canyon, which is in Red 13's land. This is also Cosmo Canyon, I think. Nibelheim. And there's Elendil.
Hold this thing over right now.
You said that Sephiroth...
Vincent!
I have a history with him.
You wouldn't believe what he can do.
Oh, we have a minigame with him now? Wait, no way they brought this. This was the card game from FF8. And I kid you not when I say this, I massacred this game. I literally got every card and I 100% my whole book. Oh, this is going to be a really long game for me. Oh no, this is going to be bad. I have to finish Persona soon. Oh, they brought back the thingy! The mini games. Okay.
Wait, don't miss on
Sid?
You'll need a way home. So when you're ready, I'll be here. An emissary from Wutai is here. Sent so? By Viceroy Saru.
With all this.
Who's the emissary from Wutai?
Goddamn blood on my hands. How could I ever hold my daughter again?
Oh, that was such a sad storyline.
Those we love, those we fear. Genova would become anyone to fool her prey.
Don't do this!
But I'm no fool.
Sephiroth! Hey!
Yo, what's going on?
Not you.
What?
Here. Take it. This isn't about me, though. It's about saving the world.
Huh?
The reunion. When spite and sorrow are harvested to feed the...
There's one winged. Bro, I'm getting shivers and chills down my spine right now. Why do I have my controller? I don't need this. Yeah, I'm getting shivers and like I am shivering. Oh my god. I cannot with this trailer. I need this game now. On two discs. Oh, I cannot wait. This is going to be the biggest content drop I have.
Final Fantasy 7 Rebirth Director の浜口直樹です。トレーラーはいかがでしたでしょうか。ここからは本作がどのようなゲームなのか。
Okay, give me more in depth. I don't care.
にご紹介していきたいと思います。
I don't care. What is it? Is this the mini game from Gold Saucer? Holy crap.
I'm waiting, Cloud.
In Final Fantasy
so I want to say something to everyone who's probably going to be like watching the VODs and stuff like that. I want to say one thing. If you guys haven't played the original game of FF7 and you think that they're spoiling way too much, I'll tell you this right now. You guys haven't even touched the surface on what they've actually done to this game. Like, disc 2 was the longest disc by far out of all three discs, and what they've shown so far doesn't even scratch the surface of what's potentially to come. That's all I'm gonna say about how big, like, did, like, imagine, okay? Final Fantasy VII, the original game, was locked onto three discs, okay? Disc 1, disc 2, disc 3. Rebirth was, or, was it Reborn? 7 Reborn was disc 1, okay? If you're gonna assume and say Rebirth was this too, you were right, or you are right. But the fact that they took the second disc and had to break it into two other discs, that just goes to show you how much more detail this game's gonna have. That's all I'm gonna say about that.
And his companions triumph over destiny. Leaving the city of Midgar behind, they step out into an unfamiliar wilderness. It is here that Final Fantasy VII Rebirth begins.
Yeah, you're gonna step out of Midgar. Yeah, right here.
The stage upon which this ragtag band story...
God, it looks so good.
...both vast and varied. The world...
Look how big that is! Like, to put it into scale, I think... I don't know, but I think... This might be as big, if not bigger, than Final Fantasy X in terms of world exploration and context. It might even possibly be, like, X2, Final Fantasy X-2 kind of world exploration where you like you have your Highwind as your hub and then you just jump ship to different locations, but the fact that you have to walk there first, it's like 10. And hopefully it's not like 10 where you go to one area, you go to the and then you go to the next mission and it's not as linear as 13-ish. Because I want to do some exploration and some side quests, but from the looks of this, it looks like it's going to be a mix between like actual original 7 and 10 with 13. Just judging from how this looks, and this map looks so beautiful. Just seeing this, I can already tell this game is going to be 100 plus hours worth of content. Just like fully doing everything. And I mean fully doing everything. I think they did say, though, that the game in itself, if you rush it, is like 60 to 80 hours. But if you want to do everything, I think they said it's like 100 plus. And I cannot wait. Also, notifications. Like, this map in itself is so beautiful. Oh, I cannot wait to deep dive into this game. And we're only 6 minutes into this dev. I do not know what else they're going to bring us.
Is made up of multiple regions, all seamlessly interconnected. The grasslands.
Oh, that's so nice.
Located due south of Midgar, this is where Cloud and the gang resume their adventure.
Oh, wait. We still have to go through this? Oh, no. This is going to give me PTSD. Okay, so context. When I was but a wee bit boy and I played this game for the first time, there's this place called the Midgar Summer Swamps. There's this place in the map. I forgot what it was called. But it's right outside the Chocobo farm where there's this swampish area. And then there's this giant ass snake shadow just lurking and doing this if you've ever played Snake, you know that pattern that it always does? Yeah, it like, or like, not Snake, if you've ever played ping pong on the like mobile phone or something, there's always a pattern where the ball goes and you just follow, go up and down depending on where the ball goes. It was like that. It's like the snake that goes around in this pattern. But the moment you touch the water, the snake chases after you. Now, your party was so weak that you'd have to level up to a point where you could actually face it, but it had a one-shot move and it literally killed your whole party if you didn't do this one-shot move or if you progressed to that point. So there was like a DPS check in a way. And if you didn't beat it beforehand, your party would just get eliminated. And this was like one of the first few, like, I guess you could say level barriers into the game. And they're repeating it now, except it's going to be in like real, like action, a real time action kind of based thing. So you could dash, dismount. I don't know what scent is. I guess you could sniff out the snake now. But before, you used to be able to see through the shadows. And when that thing hits you, that thing hits you. You notice it. Oh, God. Junon region. You could swim?
We're a metropolis by the city.
The fact they added chocobos into this game, like every single one, is amazing. I don't think they're going to add the golden one yet, but they probably should already have the river, the mountain, and I think that's the only thing we get in this too. I think we get the mixture between river and mountain at this 3 and the golden chocobo, which does everything at this 4, or this 3 as well. But the fact they added this means there's a bunch more exploration that we can do. Uh-oh, I broke it.
Same name overlooks the ocean, a symbol of Shinra's military.
God, I can't.
The Corel region. The resort town of Costa del Sol adorns its northern shore.
Oh, there's a ship!
The saucer stands as a gilded oasis above the dust bowl far to the south.
Oh, gold saucer looks amazing!
The Gungaga region.
That's what it's called, Gungaga.
To Zack by exploring his hometown. Or visit what remains of the local Mako reactor.
There's the forest thingy.
The Cosmo Canyon region. Become one with the planet.
Oh yeah, we have fly. Oh, we can fly. I forgot about the flying chocobos.
The Nebel region. take a trip down memory lane with Cloud and Tifa.
That's so nice. I'm actually both in chills and in awe at this. Like, I don't really know. So I got my 300 rule standard banner. I don't know if I should get Himiko or Claire. Whichever one you need, honestly. Or you could just save it until you get either one of them, and then just choose the one that you didn't get.
Peace. Your adventure will even extend to the high seas.
I think that was little something.
Than simply walk around, however. First, let's look at world intel. Assisting Chadley with his research will deepen his understanding of
The map is huge.
To develop new materia.
The map is actually huge. Thank God it's not just going to be a one point click thing. That's amazing. I'm going to love this game. We're going to deep dive day 1. What is Feb 29th? I don't care what it is. I'm going to call it. Wait, I have a text message. What the heck? No, what the hell? Okay, so Feb 29th, what is that day? I don't care what that day is. If it's a weekday, it's a Thursday, I'm calling it. I don't care. I'm calling it. Don't care.
This research takes many forms, such as wrangling chocobos.
It's Mog from the thingy. Okay, I gotta admit, the Moogle doesn't look as cute as the original game, but whatevs. Maybe the actual Moogle itself might be cuter.
With the Mooglets at their Mog stools, you may also come across sanctuaries brimming with knowledge.
Wait, is that Alexander?
Or lairs inhabited by fearsome, unique foes.
Who is this?
Chadley will also enlist your help in researching mysterious artifacts known as proto-relics.
What is this?
Each investigation...
It's the game! Oh my gosh, we got... Oh no, it's that one, it's that one minigame you get for getting Phoenix. It's in the Yuffie thingy too. I forgot what the minigame was called, but you get to get like... You get to be added to the game now. Oh, that's gonna be so much fun.
Featuring a colorful cast of characters, exciting new mini games, and ferocious creatures. Are you up for the challenge?
It's R2-D2.
And once you recover all the proto-relics scattered throughout the world, there's no telling what new developments might be in store.
Huh? That can't be a weapon.
Talk about odd jobs. These quests offer a deep dive into the regions of the world and the crazy characters who...
That right there reminds me of what they did back in Final Fantasy IX, where you had to sniff out certain treasure chests with your chocobo and within a time limit to get like the special equipment that it's like an endgame equipment. This is gonna be fun.
Inhabit them. As a merc,
Chicken
will accept work from people he meets in his travels and team up with his pals to solve their troubles.
Is that Kyrie?
By helping those in need, he will also strengthen the bonds between him and his comrades.
Oh god, we have mini games.
Each one of these odd jobs boasts a unique side story. Some, like Johnny's questline, borrow aspects from the original FF7, while others highlight content exclusive to Rebirth. You'll find all sorts of jobs the world over. And don't worry if you leave some for later.
Okay, here's a question. Since they just brought this out right now, can I get Tifa's final weapon? I think it was called Platinum Heart, while I'm playing the piano, or do I have to wait till this 3 for that? Because I remember distinctly that I got, kid you not, this 2, I farmed out. I don't know if it was a bug, but I farmed out so much that I got Cloud's last limit break on this 2. And same thing with, I think it was Red 13, when you go to Nibelheim, you unlock the code for the fridge. I unlocked that as early as Disc 2 as well, I believe. So, yeah. Like, really early Disc 2 before I even went to, like, as soon as I got Nibelheim, I unlocked that and Red 13 was able to learn it for his Limit Break 3. So I'm wondering if they're gonna throw in Easter eggs here and be like, hey, yo, since you did the piano, are you able to get Platinum Heart right away?
Story progression won't affect your side hustle. You can always go back to tie up loose ends And this freedom to experience the story how you want is one of Rebirth's greatest strengths.
Also, is May here? Because if May is here, I know May plays the piano. Oh no, she isn't here. But like, if May was here, just like, let her know, like, she can start playing the piano again by looking at this.
While some minigames are tied to world intel and odd jobs.
Oh, it's the, it's that punching game.
Popular ones from the Gold Saucer, such as 3D Brawler.
Oh my god, Chocobo Ring.
Chocobo Racing are in Final Fantasy VII Rebirth 2.
Nice, they made Rocket League with Red 13.
Others improve upon their remake versions, while still more are completely new to Rebirth.
Oh, we're gonna waste so much time in Gold Saucer.
We've even fleshed out some of the minigames that were featured as part of the original Final Fantasy VII's main scenario. Though this one is not in the original, I highly suggest you check out the card game, Queen's Blood. No matter where you are in the story, it's sure to both challenge and entertain you.
No, I love this.
All the cards and building your own unique decks.
I love this. I want to know how it works.
He's planning to use the Black Materia, but I won't let that happen. He has to be stopped by a Cetra, and I'm the last.
While minigames and map exploration are a big part of Rebirth's charm, there's more to it than just that. Rebirth provides a cinematic experience.
What does that mean?
With even higher quality content and more of it than Remake.
God, this song is amazing.
Follows Cloud and company after they escape Midgar up through to their arrival at the Forgotten Capital. We've taken painstaking care to depict how the group bonds during their journey.
God, this song gives me the chills every single time.
Once you finish Rebirth, I'm sure you'll agree that no other game makes you feel quite this close to its characters.
Not even him.
You sure? I don't know, man. Big doubt.
As for the graphics, Rebirth makes full use of the PlayStation 5 and its SSD.
Woo!
Meaning we could use much higher resolution assets than we could in Remake.
Oh, and God, no wonder it's two discs.
Blink of an eye. Maintain a 60 frame rate with performance mode. Or prioritize 4K resolution with graphics mode.
4K display required? Yeah, I don't have that.
Rebirth has you covered.
I'm doing performance mode, sorry.
Each character interacts with the world in their own way. Barret shoots objects. Yuffie swings across gaps.
Huh.
Tifa has her grappling gun.
Tifa has a grappling gun?
Red can climb along walls. Kate Sith grabs and throws items. And Aerith manipulates the life stream.
Oh shoot, you can manipulate the life stream.
Your teammates will be ready to help you overcome them.
That's insane.
Now for the music. We wanted to pay respect to the original FF7's tracks, but also challenge ourselves by matching the feeling of each scene, which resulted in some truly innovative arrangements.
I like it.
Like, for example, the following.
There's the high wind in the background. I don't know if you guys saw that. There's the high wind in the background right there. Says high wind. We're definitely getting it. We are definitely getting in this disc. I kind of like the original Desert Wasteland, not gonna lie.
How is that? If you enjoyed what you heard, we recorded well over 400 new tracks for this game.
Jesus Christ, that's a lot.
Thank you for choosing.
This is what I want to know.
We sincerely hope you enjoyed your trip with us.
Your party's bonds aren't just reflected in the story, but through gameplay as well. The choices you make throughout your adventure will change the way your comrades feel towards Cloud.
Yeah, at least I made that promise to you.
You're
These feelings affect who will join you on a date in the gold saucer. Something I'm sure many of you
The gold saucer date!
In fact, even allies who weren't available in the original FF7 can now accompany you, provided you play your cards right.
So you can go on a date with Yuffie now.
The saucer is packed with many incredible sights to see.
And Red 13. And Vincent. And
so
Kate Sith.
There will no doubt be a highlight of the game. Already have someone who you'd like to go with?
Yep.
You first. Cloud?
Well, we hope they feel the same way too.
Oh, that's so cute.
Your companions will share a bond not only with Cloud, but with each other as well. Your party level, a numerical expression of this bond, will increase as you overcome challenges.
I'm going to accompany you.
The higher this level, the more skills will become available in your character's folios, a mechanic new to Rebirth.
What is this?
By unlocking the skills etched in these tomes, your characters will grow stronger and learn new synergy commands.
So technically we have the same thing as, what do you call this? Sphere. The Final Fantasy X Sphere, thingy. The Sphere skill place. We have the exact same thing as that, except for it's more synergy instead of solo. Kind of cool, not gonna lie. Kind of cool.
Part of what makes Rebirth's combat so fun is all the different character combinations. Switch up your team to fit the situation, or even your mood. Every possible party combination has its own unique synergy commands. So once you find characters that work for you,
that's sick.
Focus on tweaking their skills to match your combat needs.
That's cute.
And don't be afraid to experiment.
Oh, that's so cool!
At any time. With new characters and synergy commands at your disposal.
Oh, there's so many!
Satisfying hybrid of action combat and strategic planning has been made.
Oh, Yuffie got a Naruto clone jutsu!
We can't wait for you to experience all this and more in Final Fantasy VII Rebirth on PlayStation 5.
I cannot wait.
本作のクリエイティブディレクターの野村哲也です。いかがだったでしょうか。広大な世界で描かれるクラウド
というのに
どうぞご期待ください。最後になりましたが、皆様に重要なお知らせがあります。本日より
Guys, there's a demo! Okay, context. I saw something like this earlier when I was on Instagram or like in Google News or something. I thought it was a fake. So I did not decide to like put my hopes in it. But now that I know it's actually a thing, we're gonna go play it. Hopefully the download is not gonna take too long. So we're gonna go play it. It's available today. Yep. You can play as both Cloud and Sephiroth. Let's go. I want to play as Sephi. Oh my man. Portions of Junon region to the demo? Okay. Is that Phoenix? That has to be Phoenix. So we have Phoenix on it too. Oh, I want to play it. PS5 immersion. I don't have a 4K monitor. I wouldn't want one either. I think getting a 4K monitor is useless, honestly. That's just my opinion. Oh wow, they really went all out with the controller.
Is that Muhammad Neo? Huh? This song just got me. I don't know why. 3D audio? Oh no. Why do I feel like this game is gonna make me cry? I don't know what it is, but I feel like this game's gonna make me cry. And very, very few games do make me cry. And this was actually one that actually made me depressed when I was a kid. Bro, I'm already crying at the fact of this song. I can't take this. I cannot take this. I got chills. I'm crying. I'm excited. I'm scared. I don't know what's going on. Like this song is just amazing. This song is just amazing. The fact when she does the take my hand and never let me go kind of thing, I just get chills. I begin to cry. I don't understand what's wrong with me. I don't think this is going to be a happy ending game. But we're going to look at all these little other things. Like this grassland area here, going to give me PTSD for sure. Junon looks kind of sick, not going to lie. Coral region looks kind of dope and fun. You could ride these things, which is kind of great. Gungaga, oh, that's going to give me a throwback for sure. Cosmo Canyon, we're just going to like get our minds blown. But this map, where is it? This map right here, where is it? There it is. This map. Like, there's, from what I gather, there's probably like main, this is like different side quests you could do. I think this is like different cards you can get. And I don't know what this is right here, but I think they're probably bosses. Like world bosses, which is going to be super amazing if ever that drops. Oh man, I am excited. I don't know. I don't know, man. I am too excited. And there's more regions like the Meridian Ocean and Northwood. God, this game. This actually might be game of the year if they play their cards right. Yeah. So I got